Good afternoon, everybody. A very warm welcome to Soul Food here on this Tuesday. Welcome to Tuesday, day six. Kia kaha. Again, that message today on Tuesday. It's mind, body, and soul day here on Soul Food. So it's just some food for the soul on a Tuesday. We're going to do a little bit of stuff around our minds and around our bodies as well. And we look forward to hopefully you joining in with some of that today. Just to let you know, in about 5-6 minutes time, we're going to be doing a bit of a chapel beep test. I invite you to join in with that in whatever way is appropriate for your location or your fitness. But just that we can join a little bit of physical exercise together shortly. That's coming up in just a couple of minutes from now. So welcome. Hare mai, ta whare karakia. The Lord be with you. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. So let us pray. Lord, it is day six of the lockdown. Let us be still in your divine presence. What has been done has been done. What has not been done has not been done. Let it be. Lord, it is day six. The world feels different, yet strangely becomes familiar. But there is still fear. So let our fear of these coming days rest in you. Let the quietness enable us to hear your still small voice speaking to us. And there will be an end to this, so let us look forward to new days, new joys, new possibilities. In Jesus' name. Amen. You've tuned in to Soul Food with Rev, and good to have you with us today. When I ever start an online class in the last few days, I always begin with a bit of a health check, a mind, body, and soul check. And I ask my year 9 and year 10 students, how are you feeling? How's things been for you since we last met online or since we last met at school? And so I get them just to give me a bit of a score out of 10, mind, 10, body out of 10, soul out of 10. And they just flick me an email with their name and they give me a little score out of 30. And we can check up on those that are scoring low, perhaps in different areas there, and just follow up and just find out what's going on for them. Now, guys, I guess I would like to ask, where are you today? Do your own body, mind, and soul check. What's your score out of 30 today? What has been interesting, I've been tracking this, is that some of our students are actually quite bored. So there's a little bit of low scoring going on with the mind stuff and also with the body as well. They're not feeling, some of them, motivated for exercise, particularly those that are on their own with this as well. So hopefully today we can change some of that as we exercise together today on Tuesday Soul Food, mind, body, and soul. You're listening to Soul Food with Rev, and now we're just going to have a pause. We're going to have a little piece of music, and I like this quotation from Plato. Music gives a soul to the universe, wings to the mind, flight to the imagination, and life to everything. And so we're going to play a beautiful piece of music, a piece of music I've been listening to since I was about 13, 14 years old, when I first heard it on the radio, Morning by from Peer Gynt. And as we listen, here's some pictures that I took this morning of the most amazing sunrise here at St. Paul's Collegiate School, Kirikiriwa, Hamilton, New Zealand. Enjoy. Be at peace.
Thank you.
So today's Bible reading, Jesus talks about our response to God's love being completely holistic, responding to it through our minds and our bodies and our souls. This is from Mark's Gospel, chapter 12. Jesus said, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength. The second is this, love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these." Here ends the reading. Thanks be to God. So today, Tuesday, Mind, Body and Soul Day on Soul Food, I'd like to get you to do a few challenges with me here in the chapel this morning. We're going to challenge our minds, our brains, our bodies, our physical selves, and our souls, our spiritual selves as well. We're going to do a little bit of exercise in all of those three key areas of our being, to what it is to be a human being, is to be mind, body, and soul. We have a mental, physical, and spiritual self. So the first exercise is, we'll give you 1 minute now, how many triangles can you see? 1 minute starting from now. Nearly there. Okay, so how many did you get? There's actually 24 triangles there. And there's an image on your screen right now showing you how you can find all those triangles. Okay, 24 triangles. So they're just a bit of exercise for our mental selves. I think most of our students probably didn't need that at lunchtime after four busy periods this morning, but maybe some of our other viewers enjoyed that as well. Okay, moving on to the next thing. We've got a 15-minute big test here in chapel this morning. Okay, basically I'm going to try and perform at my best and encourage you to perform at your best. I've got the shorts on, I've got the sports shoes on today here in chapel. Warming up. Okay, let's give a bit of a warm up. Stretch it out. Let's go for it. Okay, the beat test. Okay, I'm not so good at these. Are you ready? Right, okay. All set? Let's go. Right, the first beat. Should have done this the other way around. So that's the first two areas, mind, mental, body, physical. Firstly, finally, the soul, our spiritual exercise. Very easy to do that. We are still. Be still and know that I am God. So let's do that together now, just for a couple of minutes, stillness, and I can catch my breath. The closing prayers. So I think I've just about got my breathing under control. Certainly enjoyed that brief moment of stillness there as well. And the exercise of the soul, the spiritual exercise. Today, a lot of people use the term mindfulness, and mindfulness is a very powerful weapon in the battle against stress and disease. But it's a spiritual exercise. It has a much broader and deeper root than mere mindfulness. Christianity is for a long time has used meditation and prayer and stillness in God's divine presence. And that's what this form of exercise is all about, being still in the presence of God. As the psalmist wrote, "Be still and know that I am God." So I'll leave that with you. It's Tuesday, it's Mind, Body and Soul Day. We'll be back with some more exercises next week. But just remember that we exercise our bodies a lot, but our bodies will fail. They will let us down. The aging process will see to that, just like it will see to the power of our minds. They too will deteriorate over time. Our souls, every minute that we spend in spiritual exercise has an eternal consequence for us and those around us. Every minute. Not one single minute is wasted in spiritual exercise. Remember, you're not stuck at home. You're safe at home. Let us pray. Dear God, we give you thanks that we are lovingly and wondrously made in your image. We are people with minds and bodies and souls. Bless us in our endeavors to exercise spiritually, mentally and physically, and so equip us for all that you call us to do and to be during today and the rest of these days. Be with all those who are struggling with life today. We pray for those who suffer in body, mind or spirit. We pray for all those on the front lines of healthcare systems and delivery systems. Bless us, bless this nation, our leaders and our world. In Jesus' name, amen. Short time for our own prayers. And so we pray together the words of our Lord's Prayer in Tadeo or in English. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Couple of notices for you all. Tomorrow is Wednesday, and Wednesday is Where's Rev Day. So tomorrow I'm going to be somewhere on the school site with my laptop, with the sound effects, with the music. Going to guess where I am. First person to guess, phoning in or texting in or messaging in or emailing in, will get an Easter egg sent out to them. That's tomorrow. Big shout out to something much more sophisticated than I was talking about earlier in terms of scores out of 10 for mind, body and soul. This is the new Komodo app, which every staff member, every student will have now on their devices. They're being encouraged to complete a questionnaire every Tuesday and every Thursday to make sure that we can monitor how we're all tracking. All of us are in this together. And we can just help one another out, particularly those who might be feeling life's getting a little bit too much for them. It's a fantastic system. A big shout out to Mr. Hardman and all those who have been involved in the rollout of Komodo across SPC. So don't forget, you'll get that questionnaire today and Thursday. Get that sorted out. If you haven't got it yet, if you've got issues, just get in touch with your housemaster as the screen instructions suggest. Soul food, it's for everyone. If you want to watch live, there's some details there about it. Just send me an email as well. Of course, new YouTube channel, and there was something great put up there yesterday from our amazing prefect. So I commend that to you. Kia kaha. You've been listening to Soul Food with Rev on Mind, Body and Soul Tuesday. Thanks for listening. Let us bow our heads and seek God's blessing upon us. May the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and our minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, be upon you, be upon all those whom you love, care for and pray for, this day and always. Amen. We'll sing together three verses of Amazing Grace. Hopefully we're a bit better than what we did on Sunday, because now we've got some amazing music from Mr. Carpenter and Miss Bryan. Thank you so much for working so hard on the music and providing that for us today, you guys. God bless you for that. Let's stand and sing together to the best we can, Amazing Grace.
I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Through many dangers, toils, and snares, I have and grace will lead me when
fantastic, great singing and fantastic music. Thank you, Mr. Carpenter and Miss Bryan. Awesome work on those cymbals. So let's conclude our service by saying together the words of St. Paul's Grace in Tireo and in English. Kito kia tato katoa, te ata whaia te tato ariki, a ihu karaiti. Me te araha o te atua, me te whiwhina taitama, ki te wairuru tapu, ake, 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 amen. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be always with you, forever and ever. Amen. So let's go today in the love of God, the peace of Christ, and the dignity of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Kia kaha, kia hari, kia tapu. Be strong. Be happy. Be holy. Amen. Thank you.